Hello everybody, my name is Robert Dunt and I'm the founder of ArtTop10.com and I'm really excited to be here today with a wonderful artist, Andrew Grassie. Hey Andrew.
Thank you, Robert.
And so, if you haven't seen Andrew Grassie's work before, and honestly what you really need to do is see it in the flesh, because it is an extraordinary, intricate, remarkable thing. But Andrew's works are on paper and they're egg tempera. So Andrew, maybe just tell them a little bit about what egg tempera actually is.
Well, what I do, Robert, is every morning I come in and crack about three eggs. Free-range eggs. The way I use it is quite a simple process, really. It can be complicated with grinding all the pigments.
But, okay.
The pigments that I choose, they kind of dissolve into the egg yolk quite nicely, so that it's literally now just mixing the pigments with the egg yolk, and I have a bit of whiting or chalk in the pigments to kind of unify the texture of the mold, because each pigment when it's ground is a slightly different texture. I just work with six colours, a little sort of kids painting pot thing. So I have a sort of red, yellow, blue, use brown and black and white. So that's the entire colour range of these paintings. It's just with the six colours. So. Yeah, and then I work on paper because I quite like the slight absorbency that the paper has, you know. But it is gessoed paper. And then it's just a lot of time.
A lot of time.
That's a secret ingredient.
Exactly. So how long would say this painting here take?
They vary a little bit, but about 6 weeks was
about the comfortable
amount. One month to 6 weeks.
Because. It might be a slightly bizarre question, but I've become obsessed recently with watching films of people climbing free solo, where they have no rope and they just climb up 3,000 foot up Yosemite, and if they fall off, they die. And I can't help feeling that this work has an element of that, because if it goes wrong, this is quite unforgiving, isn't it?
It is, and if a cup of coffee spills on it, that's the end of the story as well.
So, yeah.
I've had some real trouble with the painting in some one or two of the paintings when I've had to scrape a section back. You know, I've worked for hours and hours and days on, say, the floor of one of the paintings.
Yeah.
But what you can do, I discovered, you can scrape with this new blade, you can scrape right back to the gesso.
Really?
Then you've got to build up the layer, up to the layer of the paint, which on the surrounding area is like a millimeter. Yeah, half a millimeter or something. And then you can restart painting. It's a bit of the process, it's something I did once in one of the paintings here, because the more I worked on the floor, the sort of more horrible textural build-up it had, and it got in the way of the... My paintings, I don't like people really to see the effort, in one sense. I mean, they're conscious of it, but I don't want them to see the struggle.
Okay.
I want it just to look like it's sort of floated onto the paper.
It's just miraculously.
Yes, like a photograph as well.
Well, they are. I mean, it's one of the most amazing things, the way they look when you see them up close. It's hard to believe you actually did them, in a way.
For me too.
For me, Bumbleclat.